When I was an undergraduate, I graduated with 3 degrees at once in mathematics, English literature, and religious studies of all topics. And the two things I swore I would never, ever study were education and psychology. But you know, we tend to dismiss or dislike the things we know the least about. So time passed, and I ended up doing my master's and PhD in exactly educational psychology related topics. And the work that changed everything in my understanding of what those fields were about and what the enterprise of education were about was Jerome Bruner. And I remember when I was in grad school, I remember he had published a study that was just a quick write-up about this wonderful interactivity he did with very young elementary school teachers, where rather than walking through what's important on a map or how to think about geography, they just busted out this real-world map and asked small children, what do you need for a city to thrive? What should a city have? And kids had the most amazing answers. And so I wrote him as a grad student, you know, scared of this amazing author, and I wrote him an email and said, you know, you never told us the results of this study. And we ended up having this email exchange, and it changed actually everything that I was doing in my life, because for the first time I realized that that arts and aesthetics and fun and play and all of that beauty should and can be part of what it means to be engaged in learning. And that the moment you take passion and interest and fun out of learning, then you've in fact killed the very enterprise. Our goal as teachers, I'm a teacher too, and our goal ought to be to actually persuade students of what is the contribution that our domain makes to actually improving the quality of our life, of our understanding day to day. And so Jerome Bruner did that for me.